The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus went on to say, "What do you think of this? A man had two sons. He went to the first and said to him, 'Son, go and work today in my vineyard.' The son answered, 'I don't want to be. I don't want to.' But later he thought better of it and went. Then the father went to the other son and said the same thing to him. This son replied, 'I will go, sir.' But he did not go. Which of the two did what the father wanted?" They answered, "The first." And Jesus said to them, "Truly I say to you, you publicans and the publicans and the prostitutes are ahead of you on the way to the kingdom of heaven. For John came to show you the way of goodness, and you did not believe him, but the publicans and the prostitutes did. You were witnesses of this, but you neither repented nor believed him." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear friends in Jesus Christ, if you have heard of generational curse. Pute, can you repeat all children? Generational curse. Can you all say? What? Generational curse. Not enough. Louder. Generational curse means you are cursed by in your generation. You are doomed because of your generational sin. Because your grandmother, grandfather, or great-grandmother and father, because of their sins, you're going to suffer. So this is what we call generational sin and generational curse. My dear friends, if you go to the Bible and if you read it carefully, which we hardly do, that's another side of the story. If you read Exodus chapter 20, the Lord is cursing them for adultery and apostasy, idolatry, because he is cursing for generations. I will curse you, and this curse would be there for generations. If you read book of Samuel, you find where the Lord is cursing David because he fell into sin with Bathsheba and Uriah's wife, and he killed Uriah, and that's where he cursed David. He said, "I will give you life. You won't die because of this. But then this will happen in your generation." So in the same way, if you find Abimelech, he did the same thing. Falling into sin with David's wives. So because of that curse. So but then today gospel, this concept of generational sin was there in the Bible. But then today's gospel speaks the other way about. The first reading says, you are going to suffer, you will be doomed, you will be condemned, not because of other sins, but because of your sins. So that's the kind of teaching the Lord is teaching us today. Because my dear friends, earlier they understood because of my parents that I am going to suffer. If you read Luke chapter 9, John chapter 9, when there was this blind man. So they believe if you are crippled in any way, if you are poor, if you die early, if you are with sicknesses and all that, and it's because of God's curse. So there comes this blind man. When Jesus asks, when the disciples ask, why he is blind? Because of his sins or his parents' sins? The Lord says, no, he's blind not because of their sins, but rather he's going to experience the power of God, glory of God through this sickness. So this is the kind of understanding that we have to fathom today. Understand today. Where the Lord is saying, if the wicked man dies doing wicked things, he will be doomed. He will be condemned. But then if the wicked man throughout his lifetime, he does wicked things, bad things. But then at the end, if he is repented and had a metanoia, change of heart, he will be saved. And vice versa, you find if a good man does good things throughout his lifetime, at the end he falls into sin and he will be doomed and condemned. The Lord is saying, I'm not unjust, this is the justice that I'm doing. But dear mighty friends, if you find Buddhist philosophy, if you know it properly, we find we had this concept called karma. And karma and pin, the good deeds and the bad deeds, you measure them all. If you do in your life all the good stuff, good things, and also bad, at the end it will be measured. The amount of good that you did and amount of bad that you did, and accordingly you will have the next life. You'll be rewarded and you will be punished accordingly. But then we don't believe that. Rather, the Lord is saying, you can do many good things. But then, at the point of death, if you belong to devil, if you do something bad, which means you belong to devil, and you're lost, you're done. Remember, our religion is a relationship. Our religion is a relationship. My dear friends, that's where we have a relationship with God. God always said, I'm the shepherd and you're my sheep. God said, I'm the husband and you're my wife. And God always said, I'm your friend. And he made a covenant. Covenant means a treaty, a relationship, a bond between two parties. So God always wanted the relationship to be firm and strong. Where always people of Israelites, they all failed to be faithful to that bond. So they all failed it. They all became unfaithful. We call it apostasy. Where when Baal and Asherah, all the other gods were there, they were distracted because of it. It's like adultery in marriage. You go after other beliefs. My dear friends, that's the nature of us. You know, moment we fall, moment we are weak, and moment we are lost, we want some tangible answer, and we go to other beliefs. Today, of course, we don't have Asherahs and Baals, you know. But then we have our own understanding and own answers. And we have our own ways of finding answers. The world will propose many things. So that's where the Lord wanted us to be faithful.